If you're over 50 and feel like your body's been acting weird lately, but can't exactly put your finger on what the problem is, this video is for you. I'm talking about random skin changes, stubborn belly fat, interrupted sleep, or even odd blood work that your doctor just shrugs at. Most people think these things just come with aging, but in reality, they can be sneaky signs of insulin resistance. And here's something most people won't tell you. Insulin resistance isn't just about your blood sugar and your weight. Sometimes the warning signs show up as skin tags, a weird fat pad on your upper back, or waking up like clockwork at 2 a.m. every night. So in today's video, I'm going to be going over 7 overlooked signs of insulin resistance that often show up after 50. So if you've been told by your doctor that everything's normal, but you still feel like something's off, this video is for you. And the earlier you spot these signs and start making changes, the faster you can turn things around. Because even after 50, it's not too late. Another thing a lot of doctors won't tell you is that insulin resistance is reversible. It isn't just something you have to live with. I'm Kait, a nutritionist who specializes in insulin resistance and blood sugar control. I've helped hundreds of clients reverse insulin resistance naturally through diet and lifestyle changes. And what I'm going to talk about today is based on peer-reviewed research and also real-world results. So let's get straight into it. Sign number one is elevated triglycerides and low HDL cholesterol. There's so much emphasis on LDL, but triglycerides and HDL actually tell us more about our metabolic health, about our insulin sensitivity, and our overall disease risk. If triglycerides and HDL are off, these are major clues that something's not working properly with your metabolism, independent of whether LDL is high or low. Even if your fasting blood glucose is normal, or even your A1C, you can still have insulin resistance. This is because insulin resistance usually shows up years before blood sugar starts to climb. What happens is that your body keeps pumping out more and more insulin to keep your blood sugar stable. And over time, that excess insulin changes how your cells respond. And when this happens, you're going to see higher triglycerides and lower HDL in your blood work. And you can use these two numbers to calculate your triglyceride to HDL ratio. Ideally, that ratio should be under 2. Anything above that signifies some level of insulin resistance. Number 2 is darkened patches of skin, and especially around the neck, in the armpits, and in the groin. And this is a telltale sign that your insulin levels have been high for a long period of time. When there's too much insulin circulating in your blood, it stimulates skin cells to grow and causes pigmentation to darken. It's most common in people with insulin resistance and metabolic syndrome, and it often shows up before your blood sugar gets flagged as abnormal. So if you've noticed these patches of skin starting to develop as you've gotten older, it's not something to ignore. It's not just a cosmetic issue. Your skin is trying to tell you something about what's happening inside. Number 3 is waking up in the middle of the night, around 2 a.m. If you find yourself waking up this time wired for no reason, insulin resistance could be to blame. When you're insulin resistant, your body struggles to regulate blood sugar levels properly, especially overnight. So after dinner, especially if it was a dinner that was high in carbohydrates, your blood sugar spikes, insulin kicks in to bring it down, and sometimes it overcorrects. This leads to a crash in the early morning hours. And that drop triggers your stress hormones like cortisol and adrenaline, which spike and wake you up. And this is a common symptom that I see in clients who are over 50. It's also the reason why so many people report worse sleep as they age. Hormonal changes, reduced muscle mass, and a slower metabolism all play roles in making us more insulin resistant over time, even if our habits, our diet, our lifestyle hasn't changed much. Number 4 is skin tags, and these often occur around the neck, in the armpits, but they can also appear on your eyelids. These may seem harmless, and skin tags themselves actually are, but the reason they develop is because of high insulin levels. It's a myth that skin tags are caused by friction. Otherwise, why would they develop on our eyelids? Insulin is a growth hormone, and when it's too high, it can stimulate excess skin cell growth. That's why skin tags are so common in people with insulin resistance and conditions like PCOS and type 2 diabetes. And just to reiterate, even if your blood sugar levels are normal, that doesn't mean your insulin levels are. But if you're pre-diabetic, that means that your insulin has been high for years, and you know that you're insulin resistant. Number 5 is a buffalo hump. This is a fat pad on the upper back or neck area. It's one of those signs that people often blame on posture or aging, but it can be linked to hormonal imbalances, especially elevated insulin and cortisol. High insulin levels signal the body to store fat, and over time, the distribution of fat starts to change. Instead of storing fat in healthier areas like the hips and the thighs, it gets redistributed to the belly, neck, and upper back. And this is especially common in women after menopause. During this time, estrogen levels drop and insulin resistance increases naturally. Now, increasing insulin resistance at this time is normal, but if you had any level of insulin resistance before menopause, then it compounds. And that's why these signs start to show up after 50. Number 6 is blurred vision or difficulty focusing, especially after meals. Have you ever eaten lunch or dinner and then felt like your eyes were a little blurry or your brain just went foggy? This can happen when your blood sugar spikes and then crashes after a meal. When you're insulin resistant, your body can't handle glucose efficiently, especially if the meal was high in carbs or sugar. And the result can be blurry vision, trouble focusing, or even a little lightheadedness. This happens because your blood sugar swings affect how your brain and eyes function. They are very sensitive to glucose levels. And finally, number 7 is increased belly fat, even if your diet hasn't changed. This is probably the most frustrating one, and again, very, very common. And once again, it comes down to high insulin. When insulin levels are high, this signals your body to store fat. So even if you're not overeating, but your baseline insulin is high, your body is more likely to store fat instead of burning it. And this isn't about how many calories you're eating. This is about what your hormones are telling your body to do. And unfortunately, as we age, our ability to build and maintain muscle declines, our metabolism slows, and years of a high-carb, low-protein diet start to catch up. Belly fat, and specifically visceral fat, which is the hard fat that surrounds your organs, is a major sign of insulin resistance. And it's not just about looks. It's a health risk. This type of fat is metabolically active, and it's actually inflammatory. The good news is that this fat is often the first to go when you start to reverse insulin resistance. Now, before we wrap up, I wanted to give you one final bonus sign that is actually the clearest indicator that you're insulin resistant, and that is high fasting insulin levels. Now, this isn't one that you can see from the outside. You do have to get a blood test in order to know where your insulin levels are at. And a lot of doctors, unfortunately, will not run this test. It's not included in routine panels. We already spoke about how insulin levels can be high years before blood sugar starts to creep up. And that's why knowing where our insulin is at is so important. Now, you can ask your doctor to run the test, but often it isn't covered by insurance. And if your doctor refuses to do it, which honestly happens more often than not, there is one company in the United States that has an at-home testing kit. And that's the Weight Biology Kit from Sowell Health. This kit allows you to test your fasting insulin at home. No doctor's appointment needed. It also uses your fasting insulin to calculate your HOMA-IR score, which is a formula that combines your fasting insulin and glucose to tell you how insulin sensitive you are. This basically looks at your fasting insulin and your fasting glucose and tells you how much insulin is needed to keep your blood sugar where it is. And that's why it can catch insulin resistance early. On top of that, this kit also tests your triglyceride to HDL ratio, which we spoke about earlier, your TSH levels, and your B12 levels. It's basically a full body metabolic snapshot. You can test now and then again in 6 months to monitor your progress. Like I said, that's available in the United States only. I'll put the link in the description box down below, and you can use code KATE10 at checkout to save 10%. Okay, so now we've spoken about signs that you are insulin resistant, but what can you do about it? Now, I do have tons of videos on this subject on my channel, but I'm going to give you a quick overview of some small changes you can make to get you started. First thing you're going to want to do is prioritize protein at every meal. Aim for 30 grams minimum if possible, ideally quality animal protein. The next thing you're going to want to do is to be smart about your carbohydrates. Stick to whole food sources and avoid anything that's processed or refined. Now, if you do eat a meal that's high in carbs, go for a 10 to 15 minute walk after you eat, because this blunts the glucose spike and less insulin will be needed. You can also use targeted supplements that have been clinically proven to help control blood sugar and insulin levels, things like berberine or inositol. And the final thing you're going to want to do is to stop grazing all day. Avoid snacks. Give your insulin a break by spacing out your meals. You don't have to overhaul your whole life. Small changes done consistently are what lead to lasting results. And if you start implementing these steps and want to track your progress, that's where the Weight Biology Kit can be super handy. Again, I'll put that down below. Now, I want to hear from you guys. How many of these signs have shown up for you after you turn 50? Let me know down below. And if you did find this video helpful, you'll also like my video on the best 8 foods you can eat every single day that help to improve insulin sensitivity. I'll link that on the screen now. Thanks guys for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.